Designed with the aim of harnessing the power of the sun to earth, ITER will be the largest and most powerful fusion machine in the world. Fusion reactions will take place inside the vacuum vessel, which is a double-walled stainless steel container where there is a vacuum and where plasma necessary for the fusion reactions is confined. The vacuum vessel is made up of 9 gigantic D-shaped parts known as sectors. Europe, through Fusion for Energy, is responsible for manufacturing and delivering 5 of the 9 sectors. F4E works together with 8 European companies in the manufacturing design, material procurement, manufacturing and delivering. Fusion for Energy will provide sectors 5, 4, 3, 2 and 9 of the ITER vacuum vessel. Each sector is 6.5 meters high, 3 meters wide and 6.3 meters deep and will weigh around 500 tons. The remaining 4 vacuum vessel sectors come from Korea. Other important parts come from Russia and India. And all of these interfaces need to fit together. It's like trying to make a big puzzle where you've never seen all the different pieces fit together.
As Fusion for Energy, we collaborate with the ITER-IO, other European companies, and also other companies in the world. For the vacuum vessel manufacturing, it is necessary to work with many partners because there is not one single company in Europe that can do the whole job. So what we have been doing is work together with the AMW Consortium, is made of 3 partners, Ansaldo, Mangiarotti, and Walter Tosto, together with their main sub-suppliers, European companies from Italy, Spain, Germany, and France. The manufacturing of the vacuum vessel is very challenging. It has very unique shapes. It is, in fact, the first of a kind, and it requires a unique design. In addition, it has to be manufactured according to the French nuclear standards, and on-time delivery would be meaningless if it was not manufactured according to the highest quality standards.
The manufacturing of 5 sectors of the vacuum vessel require a big effort in terms of manufacturing capacity, especially to cope with the time frame of the project. The complexity of this structure requires a big effort in terms of coordination and interface management. We are doing activities in our shops that have never been done before.
We build up an enormous amount of knowledge, organizational knowledge, technical knowledge, that we can reapply to our other deliveries to ITER.
Besides the technical lessons that we learned manufacturing the vacuum vessel, from my point of view, the biggest one is in the way of working, in the way of working with the supplier and the way of working with the ITER international organization. We've seen companies that have started to work for the vacuum vessel and now they are applying the lesson learned to other projects also in the nuclear sector. And this, of course, is a big achievement for the European industry.